very excited to be inside the Surgeon's Hall Museum. I've studied medicine for many years. I'm interested to see what specimens they have in this hall. Museum.
Yeah.
Everyone has a favorite. Tell me your favorite.
I should say, really, I've told the story. When people come in here, certainly from outside, and they've heard about, this is not my favorite. There are two, and I will tell you what my favorite is. One of them is everybody comes and asks where the Burke skin book is. So there's a book made from the skin of the Irish guy, the murderer.
This is the Burke and Hall hair exhibit. These were the two notoriously famous murderers during the time where the trade of medical body parts was at its peak. And here we have the Burke's book. So Burke was hanged, of course. He got caught. He was hanged, and they publicly dissected him, and they used the skin to make the cover of that book.
Everybody comes here who's heard of the Burke and Hare story and comes to see that.
Wow.
But mine is something slightly different. It's a skull from a Highlander, an anonymous Highlander who was at the Battle of Culloden in the Jacobite Rising.
Okay.
Who was actually shot through the head, and there's a musket ball entry and exit wound.
Wow.
And it was found on the battlefield just, you know, a few years after the battle, allegedly. And as we've done some work on it, we've done 3D scans on it, and Historic Scotland say that it's one of the very few that exists. So, having been a military historian before I was ever here, I am kind of drawn to those sorts of objects. And we have quite a lot of objects that come from the Battle of Waterloo and all of these other places, and you can always find something new and interesting. And that particular one is of interest to me personally, but I think when anybody that comes here, there are thousands of objects on display, they will find something that draws them in.
This is the exhibit that Chris Henry finds the most interesting because he used to be an arms curator in London. All right, let's take a look here. We've got a skull here with a hole in the front and a hole in the back. Now this skull was found in a battlefield in the Highlands, and it's basically a musket ball pierced through the skull. There's the entrance wound and the exit wound, and it's quite fascinating how big the hole is from a musket ball at that during that time.
And I think it's totally fine.
Even with me, not many people know this, but yeah. I do have quite a massive collection of bayonets.
All right.
Oh, I think I have about 500 of them.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. Right.
And I also have a decent collection of knives.
Yeah, right. Okay. Well, you might be interested in that. I mean, in addition, if for military collections, there's a skull of a French soldier who was at the Battle of Pyramids in 1799, and he was attacked by a mammoth cavalryman who hit him on the head with a saber and the thing. And they're kind of snapshots in history, really, and different things appeal to different people, but there really are, there are so many different folk involved in this. And you can't sort of forget either that somebody died normally to give us one of these objects. So we always try to make sure that there's a little sense of reverence about that. The fact that, we're thousands and thousands and thousands of specimens, each one associated with an individual,
of course,
or who in some ways contributed to what this collection is.
All right. Yeah.